to how the citizens here can help the security agencies to prevent these things from happening. If you're able to prevent it, whether you have an employment or not, you have your freedom and liberty to go about living your own life. But if you allow these things to happen, even the letter that we have will be taken away from us. So let's all come together and do our bit to help to sustain the peace and security that we have. When a year ago, the Togo people, they went into police cave. They didn't reach the police.
Yes. It was the people here who suffered a little. So if we all come together as a nation, whatever you see which is suspicious, you are bold to inform the security agencies. You will be able to get intelligence out of it and stop these things from happening. If you're able to do that, then we can live our lives in a normal way. I've been asked to do a presentation on the national security framework for countering violent extremism and terrorism. The framework that national security has developed is a government society-oriented approach to solve or to prevent the occurrence of extremism and terrorism in the country. Violent extremist activities and terrorist attacks
across some African countries, especially some of our immediate neighbors in the Sahel region, serve as a continued reminder of the threat that terrorism poses both on our people and our way of life. It is the responsibility of government to put measures in place to preserve the safety and security of Ghanaians. The National Framework for Preventing and Countering Violent Extremism and Terrorism is aimed at achieving this. The National Framework is a government society-oriented approach aimed at addressing the drivers of extremism among the population. There are certain triggers that work to bring this extremism into place. Some of them can be unemployment or lack of development in a certain area. If we are not careful and we start small agitation and somebody with a very evil mind comes into the society, he can by his own schemes get people to follow him, develop an extreme opinion about the whole situation, fund it, and then get everything into a chaotic situation. So what the objective of this framework is to get the civil population well informed or well educated in gathering information so that the information can be passed on to higher levels so that decisions can be taken to forestall any extreme situations from happening and creating situations that can be very detrimental to the peace of this country. The structure that has been set up to implement this framework is made up of a national counter-terrorism center that is under the Ministry of
national security, and it is to coordinate all activities or efforts towards achieving the objectives set up in the framework. Under the National Counterterrorism Center, we have regional security councils in all the 16 regions of the country. And in every district, metropolis, and municipality, we have a DISEC or a MUSEC or a METROSEC. Through this structure, we are able to go down to the communities to solicit information to process as intelligence. The objective of this framework, is to address issues of marginalization of groups. When in a society or in a country, a certain group of people consider themselves marginalized, they become subject to being manipulated to do things that will bring chaos into the country. So this national framework is aimed at addressing this marginalization of groups. It also addresses the inequality in access to education and healthcare. It's also to stimulate economic development in deprived areas, and it is to promote intercommunal dialogue. All these are triggers that can cause chaos in the country when not properly addressed. And government, in connection with civil society groups and the citizenry, are coming together to address these issues so that even if I'm not employed, even if my area is not being developed, even if I'm marginalized, I'm in a minority somewhere, and I'm marginalized, I can be spoken to or I can be educated enough for me to wait for the time that government resources will also reach where I am for me to also benefit from it. It's not like having a family, a man, a wife, and children. The parents will not be able to satisfy all the children at the same time. But if the children understand the situation, we don't have enough cash to go around everybody, but they understand that when this man goes, the next time I'll also go, you have the patience to wait and enjoy the fruits from their parents. So, the triggers are very, very crucial. These are the things that create instability in the country if not properly addressed. And we are here to be educated so that when you go back, when we are convinced that it will not be good for us to agitate every time to have what we need, but to wait the right time when government can provide them, we'll be able to tell others to not follow any agitator and create confusion in the society. Next. The national framework is based on the following principles: education and awareness creation. A dedicated effort to educate the general public and create societal awareness on the negative effect of violent extremism and terrorism, and why we should deny recruitment and support violent extremists and terrorist ideology. I was telling you about the situation in the former Yugoslavia. In that country, there are three distinct ethnic groups. the Serbs, they have the Goats, and they have what they call the Muslims. The Muslims in that particular context is that it's an ethnic group. Even though they were Muslims, they consider themselves as ethnic group. And every town that you go, they live in separate entities. You hardly find a Muslim living among the Goats. And the same for the others. They live in separate entities. Very little intermarriages. So it was very easy for any group to attack another. Because the moment you face this direction, you know the group of people you are going to attack. And in their armed forces, the officer corps was about 80% Serbs, about 20% Croats. As for the Muslims, the other ranks. And so when there was confusion, it was easy for them to just kill almost all the Muslims. What I'm trying to carry across is that we are very fortunate that our first president did a very wonderful job for us. At the beginning of our independence, these secondary schools that were set up were organized. And all students were kept in one location in a boarding school. People came from all over the country, from every tribe, and from every community. So from the onset, whilst we are schooling, we interrelate. I can be an ordinary, but my best friend could be an airway in secondary school. So from the onset, we began to mingle together, share ideas, and live together. And that has helped this country very well. So, education and being made aware of what insecurity can bring to this country. There's nothing that happened here, just a roadblock. The things happened so much that people became confused. What if they have blown off the abuse bridge? At the end of the day, we the citizens suffer. Well, if you are not able to commute across the Adobe Bridge, then there is chaos. So all that we are saying is, give us the information. Whatever you see that is suspicious, because it could be a person, it could be an activity, it could be anything. Don't think this is a small information. Then pass it over. Your information, somebody's information, another somebody's information, when it comes to one person, he can form a picture about the situation that is happening in the area and address it. So after the education, we go to the next, the prevention. This is the priority area. We want to prevent the disaster from happening before it's solved. And the prevention comes from you and from me. Whatever we see, which is a trigger to violence, we need to report. Most of the time, I live as a shaman. And most of the confusion in Accra, generally, a lot of the source is from Accra, is from a shaman. People live with criminals and they won't report them. People live with, they know that they are criminals. But they will never, for fear there will be a retribution. But if we keep doing that, and they will grow in their criminality, at the end of the day, the suffering will be greater. So let's report. The police are here, the immigration, the other security agents, they are even opinionists. We can report to people we trust, the chaplaincy and others. Let's give them the information. They'll forward it to whatever it has to be channeled to. And those who can process it will do so and get these things prevented before they actually do happen. So, prevention and this identification of a vulnerability to the threats and building adequate resilience to prevent their occurrence. The threats are the violent extremism, and the vulnerabilities are the things, the difficulties, the challenges in society. The challenges. If you are challenged with transportation or good road networks, and you begin to agitate, and you allow somebody to fuel it, you use you to achieve his objective. The next one, human rights and the rule of law. Respect for human rights, the rule of law, and human dignity is an anchor of all effort to prevent or counter violent extremism and terror. This is a very key point. Boko Haram is Boko Haram because of the way the Nigerian military treated the leader of Boko Haram. They arrested him and dehumanized him. They brought him into the public and his dignity was completely taken away. The way they killed him fueled Boko Haram's activities. So we are not saying we shouldn't arrest terrorists and whoever, but there must be respect for his rights. And his human dignity must not be violated. Even in Australia, where we arrest thieves and robbers, look at what is happening in recent times. They tap people, their hands to their back, around pools. These are all illegalities. Let's follow the rule of law. You arrest somebody, hand him over to the police, and the police will process him for prosecution. So the rule of law is key in upholding extremism and terrorism. Yes. Good governance and social cohesion. When we were in our company, somebody was talking about what if the government is not being right, is being everything better. It could be true that the government is not going well, but in Ghana, at least since the first republic, I haven't seen any very bad governance system in this country, not yet. They may not satisfy my aspirations, but very bad governance, I'm yet to see. We should all try to put, you see, if I'm an MPP man and NDC is in power, all my effort is to bring down the government so that the next day I'll be there. I don't have a problem with that. But when it is overstretched, then there's a problem. Once you overstretch it and press on, when the elections results are announced, that is where the problem is. If you are not able to hold ourselves well, the triggers can be very, very dangerous. So let's criticize. Let's oppose. But let's keep it within limits so that we don't go overboard and create situations where extremists can take advantage of and create problems for us. Yes. All inclusive approach. The successful implementation of this program relies on a whole society and the whole government approach that involves all stakeholders, including members of our local communities. You see, the military has its own way of getting information. The police also have their way of getting information. But the police especially relies on the civil society. If they don't get the information, they can do very, very little. But if the approach is a whole society in conjunction with the whole government, seeking to prevent extremism and terrorism, it will succeed. None of us should sit aside and say, "Onyamere." Or, there's a way we say, I have nothing to lose. person stays than me, I have nothing to lose. That person becomes a danger. Because he can give in to anything that his interest accepts. If somebody comes and serves his interest, he is prepared to give whatever information he has to that individual. And as things like people who have nothing to lose, let's all continue to make this country and have a good habitation for everybody. Peace and security is key to development, to your personal development, to your societal development, and to the development of this country. If you are able to develop your personal self, it goes to enhance the development of your society and the development of this country. Next. There are four pillars on which this framework is based on. The first one is, as you have said earlier, prevent. And the prevent stage is what we are doing now, the NCC is doing now. Trying to impress on everybody, whoever you are, to contribute your quota to make peace solid in this country. Whatever you can do in your area to make a peace, to make peace reign in this country, you need to do. If you have a problem, the root cause of the problem may not be solved. We have a situation in the north. We said it was a unifier that created the Boko Haram and Boko Haram. But that was not the root problem. The root problem was there. But the unifier situation was just the trigger. If you have a problem in the society, and being academics and being youth, we need to identify the problem, go to the roots of the problem, and try to find ways to solve them. If you need some resources to get those problems solved, the appropriate authorities can be contacted so that the roots of the problem are dealt with, so that individuals who have very bad minds will not come in and capitalize on this and create chaos in the country. Look, this working program issue has been there long ago. It's only in recent times that people are trying to really agitate the minds of so many to follow through with their plan. But if we are able to get to the root of the problem, sit down with those people who are involved, try to find a workable solution to this. We will be able to live together in one country and have our peace and prosper therefore. So the prevention aspect is very key. But unfortunately, in this area of voter reading, Eastern reading, and Rita Accra, we have passed this prevention area. Go to the next one. We are in the preempt domain, where the people have already infiltrated the system. And this is where this area of land, and we are close to the epicenter of this Western Togoland problem. We may know people who know the agitators. Fortunately, when these things happen, many chiefs in the voter region were very helpful. Through them, we had a lot of intelligence and we were able to pick so many of these agitators who were creating the problem. Very soon, I think 1st September, in the anniversary, their first independent anniversary. And this is why we should be very careful. We should put our ears to the ground. We should open our eyes and see signs. Because at that time, it was roadblock and others, the anniversary could take a completely different form. We are taking measures and we are looking at triggers to see what will happen the next time. But you are the people on the ground, and we are appealing to you. Whatever you see that is suspicious, whatever you hear that is criminal in orientation, let somebody know. This gathering is just that. Getting information and passing it on. If you're able to do that, we will be able to prevent or nip these agitators and their actions in the bud. When it passes the preemptive pillar, then it enters the protection. That is more of security activity. Because in the protection, measures to protect others' interests and render safe from harm or violent extremists or attack vulnerable communities, members of the population, their property, critical infrastructure, mobility corridors and public places, as well as cyber space. In this situation, that's why they have deployed some soldiers at the bridge. We have soldiers at the dam site. We have soldiers at the Abuse dam site. Why? Because they are critical infrastructures. If anybody touches any of them, assuming the Akosombo dam is breached and what is blocking the water is removed, I think people will be back away. But from here to town, everybody will be gone. Because the speed with which the water will flow down to the sea will be extremely fast. So we need to protect these things. And as you are protecting, whatever information you get, you may not be able to be part of the protecting team, but still information is a requirement. So please, just look around. The anniversary is coming. They are going to strike again, very likely. But if you're able to get enough information, you should be able to prevent that from happening. After the protection, we go to the response. That is the full range of measures to mitigate the impact of the violent extremist and terrorist attack and recover from such incident. This is also purely security issue. Every measure is brought together to deal with the situation. Full range. So, I would repeat, get your eyes on the ball and get your ears on the ground. Whatever you see, whatever you hear, which are criminal in your orientation, let somebody know. Now, I want to, since the prevention is what I brought us here, let's look at the prevention a little bit. The objective of the preventing measures are to prevent radicalization of the youth and the vulnerable through sustained efforts at addressing government challenges. Every government has got a challenge. Ghana, our governmental challenges are more. But we should be able to wait or keep our peace. No, I'm not in any way saying that we shouldn't criticize government or we shouldn't ask government to fix the country. Governments are to fix countries. But the individuals who must also help the government to fix the country. If they are not able to help the government, they cannot fix the country. So whatever we need to do to help government bring good governance, we need to do so that these challenges are addressed. Once you have challenges and we have somebody with an evil mind trying to help us challenge government with it, once you have an answer, you can do very dangerous things and get the country into confusion. So, prevent radicalization. The next one is to introduce education awareness creation about the implications. That is all the NCC is doing. And not only the NCC, others in the newspaper, print and electronic purpose, bringing together all the people together so that we can press on and get the nation into a situation that prosperity can bring sanity into the lives of everybody. In short, what these pillars are trying to address are the challenges like the youth. You see, what do you want the video? And what I have seen elsewhere.
You hardly
see the youth when people are grouped in a concentration camp. You hardly see the youth. I was in Srebrenica when they self-attacked the Muslims. They gathered all the youth together, boys and girls. They took their girls elsewhere
and dealt with them.
Group them, did everything wrong. But the men, the young boys, they lined them up and shot all of them one after the other. It is not celebrated every year. They shot all the young men. Why? Because they are there. They are the blood of the hands. So if we were able to point them,
then they are speaking up their own way.
So
that is why
they have gone to here at the youth. Your case may be a difficult one. In case there is an attack in the area. Because you are the ones they will target. Once they're able to deal with the youth, the whole area comes under their control. So let us also help to bring down this extremists and their ideology. When we are not able to do that, they will be confused and we are disadvantaged and we shall suffer even more than the enemy. Although not comparable to other West African countries, interfaith radicalization exists in this country. While doctrinal interpretational differences are key underlying factors in the radicalization process, its mutation into violence is largely underpinned by governance issues. What we are trying to say here is that even in the Christian faith, there are a few confusion
in doctrine.
Someone who is speaking in tongues is this, doing this is this, but in our case, it doesn't reach the level where extremes and have on.
But you must be careful.
Because all these things are triggers. Even in the Muslim faith, they have they have different sects in it. And they don't agree on certain doctrines. And if you are not careful and it becomes a problem in the sect, in the faith, it can trigger a lot of confusion. And any wicked person, person with criminal act
will have on that,
fuel it with finances and create a lot of problems for everybody.
Education and awareness, this keeps coming
because that is why we are here today. Education and awareness creation. If we are not fully educated on the implications of our negligence in seeking information about terrorists and people who enjoy extreme terrorists and people who are extremely wicked in orientation, they will harp on them and within the society create enmity between sects, between ethnic groups, between whatever, not even in society, in families. When there is something to be said, it is then that you realize that this man's line is not qualified for it, this man's line is not qualified for it. It is the same in the country. Let us come together. There should be cohesion amongst us. I'm understanding. You are an elder, but we are Ghanaians. That is the key. We have, when I was in the military, my dad was Rufa, he was an ordinary. So dedicated, so committed, but he was an ordinary. It didn't make any difference. We are Ghanaians first, then we are whatever second. Keep this at the back of our minds. We will not need intercommunal violence, we will not fight each other. We will grow together in peace and enjoy the benefits of this country together. This NCC workshop is to create awareness and expose false claims in extreme narratives, extremist narratives. See, the extremists will come and give you utopian ideas that when you agree with us and we come, we form our government, we do this, we'll be able to do this and do. They are all building castles in the air. Once they come into power, it becomes something completely different. Let's hold and cherish what now. Let's align with where they are going wrong. Let's be frank. Take up is another. Let's mess up things that are wrong in society and keep at it, so that we together will be able to build a good society and benefit from the resources of this country. Next. The media are also conducting some campaign to address, to bring ideas on cohesion, living together, and safeguarding and protecting the unity of the state. Once we all understand that this country belongs to all of us, and that the resources in this country are for all of us, then we will all together be able to plan and live and guide and protect these resources.